Hi everyone, here we have another example of reducing the block diagram system into a single transfer function. As you can see here, we have g1, g2, g3, g4, and it shows the block diagrams as the blocks for the system. To start the simplification, I think I can start by moving this g2 after the summation point, yeah. So as a result, I will have this result in block diagram system. G2 will move after the summation, during the summation. And then CMS. And here we have the attack with G4 to this point. But since G2 has moved here, it appears on the path on our G3. As a result, I need to have 1 over g2 here and g3 in its place. So as a result, for c, you have the signal here times g3, and similarly here the signal here times g3 or 1 over g2 and g2. So we have the same kind of signal. Therefore, I can redraw it here again. And so these are, of course, the plus sign. G3 over G2 summation. And summation G2 G4 H and negative sign here, see. Summation with positive signs. So again, here we have two summation points, one after the other. We can just exchange the position, and what we get is this. Coming from here. G3 over G2 summation, another summation. So this time we have the loopback G4 here, G2 here, C, and H. And the output of G3 is plus. So basically, the signal that we have here, signal if I have a type E or X, whatever, the input to the G2 should be exactly the same as what we have here. And you can see that it's, in this case, it's the summation of this output for X1 plus this signal here x minus this signal x2 plus this signal here x3. And we have exactly the same case here, since we have x1 coming from this case minus x2 coming from here. So these are exactly the same in terms of the signal that we have here. However, if we have a look. Now, there's a The network here, which could be simplified, and these two branches here are parallel to each other. So we can simplify the system further. These two are in parallel with each other. So we will have GPC over GPC1. And then here we have so these two again are in series with each other. If we call the result as T, which is G3 plus G1 G2 over G2 times G2 over 1 plus G2 G4, which could be simplified further as G3 plus G1 G2 over 1 plus G2 G4. The resulting transfer function from R to C would be C over T1. And replacing T from there, G3 plus G1, G2 over 1 plus G2, G4 over 1 plus H times G3 plus G1, G2 over 1 plus G2, G4. And this could be simply passed into G3 plus G1, G2 over 1 plus G2, G4 plus H times G3 plus G1. And this will be the overall transfer function from R to C. For the provided multiple diagrams that we have here. Okay, so again, this is all for this video. I hope you have enjoyed it and found it useful in simplifying the, reducing the multiple diagram steps into a single transfer function. Thank you for watching and see you next time.